Our main goal is we want to be able to help a lot of people to be able to pay the offset of the cost usually happens from, you know, your major medical where it falls off. Because most major medical don't pay for your whole insurance. You still got the deductibles you got to come out of, the co-payments you got to come out of. And, you know, like let's say, for example, somebody got diagnosed with cancer, you know, and, you know, that being a leading cause of death right now. I mean, you want to make sure that you still have a lot of money still left over. But your major medical is only going to pay like 37%. Okay, she got 6-7% you got to come out of. Okay, where we come in is we offset and we pay the rest of that cost is 6-7%. Okay, so is it good to have something like that?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it is. Okay, because in most cases, one thing we usually find is that most people usually don't have enough reserve cash funds ready for medical bills. Mm-hmm. And what's the major reason why most people go into bankruptcy? Medical bills. Okay, those hospitals, they don't put no cap on them. Okay, they can charge as much as they want to charge. Okay. But, you know, even now with the Obamacare and everything that's going on, you know, they're not even allowing you to get the supplemental insurance unless you have comprehensive insurance, you know, in advance. Okay? So, because they know that's going to help with that, some people are going to try to replace that for major medical. So, you know, but supplemental is for supplemental. Supplement your income. Major medical is designed to pay, you know, the majority of the insurance bills. But then again, you still got a lot of costs still involved. Mm-hmm. But we cover those things through the mm-hmm. process of the vehicle of an accident, cancer, disability, critical, anything, stroke, heart attack, anything you think of. It covers it. It pays you the money, but it pays the money directly to you instead of the doctors and, you know, hospitals.